The legend lives on from the Chippewa down up the big lake they call Gitchagumi. The lake, it is said, never gives up for dead when the skies of November turn gloomy. But the load of iron ore, 26,000 tons more than the Edmund the Fitzgerald weighed empty. That big ship and true was a bung to be chewed when the gales of November came early. The ship was the pride of the American side, coming back from some mill in Wisconsin. As the big breeders go, it was bigger than most, with the crew and good captain well seasoned. Concluding some terms with a couple of steel firms when they left fully loaded for Cleveland. And later that night when the ship's bell rang, it'd be the north wind they'd been feeling. The wind in the wild made a tattletale sound. Every man knew as the captain did too, 'twas the witch of November come stealing. The dawn came late and the breakfast had to wait when the gales of November came slashing. When afternoon came it was freezing rain in the face of a hurricane west wind. Supper time came, the old cook came on deck saying, fellas, it's too rough to feed you. At 7 p.m. a main hatch we gave you, and he said, fellas, it's been good to know you. The captain wired in, he had water coming in, and the big ship and crew was in peril. And later that night when his lights went in sight, in the wreck of the Edmund the Fitzgerald. Does anyone know where the love of God goes when the waves turn in minutes to hours? The searchers all say they made Whitefish Bay, they put 15 more miles behind her. They might have split up, but they might have capsized, they may have broke even to the water. And all that remains is the faces and the names of the wives and the sons and the daughters. In the rooms of their ice water mansion, old Michigan steams like a young man's dreams. The islands and bays are the sportsmen. Farther below Lake Ontario takes in what Lake Erie can send her. And the iron boats go as the mariners all know, with the gales of November remember. Maritime Sailors Cathedral. The
church bell chimed till it rang 29 times for each man on the Edmund Fitzgerald. The legend lives on from the Chippewa down of the big lake they call Kitchigoomy. Superior, they say, never gives up pretty.